Good day. So you're joining me on this very windy day, and I want to talk about three, well, yeah, let's say important things today. Interesting start of the video. So the first thing I want to talk about is the Mifesto meet. And I already said you guys that it would be 14th September, or Saturday, September the 14th. We're gonna meet there at 10:30-ish. I'm probably gonna be a little bit later myself. I hope 10:45. Then we can do some talking, some socializing. Meet some vloggers you might want to meet, or throw out some collaboration ideas on the table to see if anyone wants to work with you, because this meet is mainly vlogger based. Of course, if you're a subscriber, you're welcome to come, but I'm not going to share it out on any other platform, so that if you're not watching my videos, then you're probably not aware of this meetup. And we're gonna probably ride at 11:30, 11:45. Why this late? Well, I want to give Lid and Borboni as a bike a chance to come, and they're both doing this new pump up program on a Saturday morning with the Mad Masters run following, so I want to give them some time to come. And the Friday up front, I'm having a big birthday of somebody, so I won't be home early, most likely. So I need to have some time to, you know, sleep out and wake up. I know where we are now. Wait. This is no longer allowed. Let's see, how bad is it? I want a big all-rounder. So yeah, if you want to come at 11:30, we will be still be there. So if you only want to ride, or if you're coming from fur, you don't have to leave as early. But for some of the Belgian friends, for example, might be better. We have had multiple Belgian vloggers on the meets before. Doable. Oh, so doable. Saturday, September the 14th. We're leaving 11:30, 11:45 from McDonald's Barendrecht. So yeah, that's point one. Second point I want to talk about is that I have a new logo. You won't believe it, but I finally got myself a semi-decent logo. I've been rocking the old one for quite some time, and it was okay-ish. It wasn't high quality, but it was good enough to show my videos. Okay, this is my video. Now I got a better looking logo, one that tells people from the logo what it's all about. Yes, it includes a helmet like many other logos out there, but I gave it my own twist. As you can see, there is a gecko on the logo. The gecko itself is designed of the Lepidoptilus lugubris, which is a gecko species I keep a long, long time. I had that gecko before I had my license for the motorcycle, I think. And I'm in generation, I don't know how far. Normal age is 4 to 6 years. The oldest female disappeared around the time she was about 6 years old. Downside of very big enclosures for small animals, sometimes they just disappear. So you will see that on the right downside corner as a brand, a watermark. You'll see that in the new intros. You will see that on all my social media, because the moment this video hits, I will slowly change all social media over to the new logo. And I'm really happy with the logo. Turned out better than anticipated. Nice small roads here. At the moment of filming this, the intro is still a work in progress, but I see no reason of why that would become a problem. So after this video you might encounter some videos with the old intro, because I have been pumping up quite some videos pre-edited already, because I know there's a busy period coming up where I don't have the opportunity to edit, so I'm editing a little bit up ahead. And with the logo there also comes a possibility for better stickers, for actually stickers, which I'm looking forward to. So it also gives me the chance to make other merch, like business cards. But yeah, business cards are something that has been in my head for quite some time already, especially for the review stuff, for the motorbus, for whatever. So I'm getting the ideas to get those made as well. But yeah, the new logo might get some getting used to, but it is here and I'm happy with it. Rebranding always takes a lot of time, a little bit of effort of course, some patience to get everything right. And the first thing I wanted to talk about is I have yet again changed the position of the mic, because when I was listening to my speakers the audio was fine, but now that the girlfriend is back I'm listening to audio a lot more through the headphones and it still seemed a bit metallic. Other people said so as well. Because other people said so as well, I've been changing a little bit of things, I'm asking some advice. In this video we are experimenting with two things. And this video will be chopped up in four parts. And I will have a digit in the left hand side corner. So if you're wondering why the digit was there, now you know. I'm not gonna tell you exactly which part is which setup. So one of the four is the original audio, one of the four is the audio originally but with some edits or editorial equalizer stuff, which Lid gave me a tip on, Lid Rides, so thank you Lid Rides. Another one is a new mic position. And I followed the advice of Hippo Drones in that situation. He has the same helmet, so let's see how that works. And the last option, which could be the very first part you listen to, and we'll shuffle them, is Hippo Drones' position with the equalizer editing advice from Lid Rides. Just to make it equal. So edited could be also compared to edited. Now of course I want to see in the comments which one is better. So what I would prefer to see, other than any compliments to the new logo and people saying they will attend the meetup, is just numbers. 1, 2, 3, or 4. A number corresponds to whatever setup audio wise you would think was the best one. So I know which setup belongs to which number, and if you guys only put a number down there in the comments, I can pick the better setup out of those numbers. This is the best way to notice any difference at all by putting everything in one video and comparing it to each other. However, I've also been rambling on for quite some time, so it might be smart to just say thank you guys for watching. Let's see if you can get at least 20 comments down below.